And for the church in mission, the global reality is not like an extracurricular activity. It is not an appendix. It is a part and parcel of our identity as a universal church, Catholic church, you know, where universal love is operating, where through the presence of people from different countries, then we know that the love of God in Jesus is universal. And you find a brother and sister in everyone, especially in the poor. You know? And so the message of St. Paul, in Jesus Christ, we belong to one another. There is no Jew or Gentile, rich or poor, slave or free, male or female. We are, so this communion of humanity, the communion of creation in Jesus, and the presence of missionaries from different parts of the world, in different territories, in different contexts, and living in community is a living gospel. Now, as we talk about globalization, as we talk about communion, as Pope Francis talks about universal friendship, fratelli tutti, and caring for our common home, etc., we see a lot of divisiveness in the world. We see a lot of suspicion of the others. We see a lot of fear towards the others, leading even to violent acts, you know? And which makes us sad, but at the same time, it is an opportunity to affirm the gospel of love and universal fraternity, brotherhood, and friendship. And for us in the church to be also vigilant, because this divisiveness, you know, along ethnic lines, along even tribal, linguistic lines, racial lines, you know, what we see in the world has also its consequences and has a presence even within the church. And so there is a missionary consequence if the Christian community cannot embrace, the members could not embrace each other as brothers and sisters, the non-Christians looking at them would say, what gospel is that? You know, so communion within the Christian, the community of Christians, is not just for smooth relationships. No, it has a missionary value. One, whether a priest or a religious or a lay person who chooses to be lay, you know, each one has a unique process in determining what gift has God given to him or to her. Now, and a vocation is a response to that gift. So what I would like to tell young people especially is not to be afraid to engage in the process of finding out that gift. There is no, I think, recipe that will fit everyone, because everyone is called in a unique way. But I would tell people not to be afraid to engage in that discernment, to trust the Word of God, listen to the Word of God, and see in the Word of God, the Bible, the wisdom that would clarify for each one what might be going on in me. The ministry to migrants, you know, especially by the church, and the social and charity organizations of the church, is the great bringer of hope to those people who are uprooted and feel lost, you know, in a foreign land, etc. No, so when they see that there is there are individuals and communities who really care for them and who will not leave them alone, then their pain is transformed to strength. No, if they are made to feel, you know, that they're human beings, respected and given the opportunities to bloom, they become an asset to the receiving country. No, they provide workforce, they provide quality work because they are accepted, and they also are able to help their families back home. So the workers, the migrant workers, could become the human bridge between two countries or more countries and cultures. I always try to learn from the little ones. You know, I say, even if I can contribute to them, I can teach, but I should be a student of the little ones, because they have a wisdom that academics don't have. They know what hope is, you know, from their suffering. They know what love is and sharing in their poverty, in their want. You know? They know what faith is, even when it's so difficult to say, "Our Father, give us this day our daily bread," because they know there will be no bread. But they know there is faith. They know by faith what it means. And so we have to learn from them. We should really work so that the basic human necessities that every human being, dignified human, deserves must be given to them, not just as promises. You know, I think that's part of our service to them, not just to say in words that they are dignified, but to take action, you know, and to propose some changes in mentalities, in policies, in the economy that keep the poor poor. And I think that's part of the affirmation of their dignity. We express our solidarity with all the people who are suffering in conflict situations. The most dramatic right now is in Ukraine, you know, but there are other conflicts raging right now in the world, and some of them have been forgotten. It seems that the violence has become worse, etc. No? When will humanity learn? Why do we keep repeating the same fault, the same mistake? When will we say the horror stories of the past will teach us now not to do it again?